through chapter visits, conferences, and even shout-outs on Facebook, you've come to know Kelcie Jones. But California FFA, we felt that there are some things that you don't really know about her. And we're here to give you the real skinny on old K. Jones.
You may be unaware that Kelcie served as a 2005 through 2011 Jones Household Professional Cage Fighting Champion, where she constantly gave me Indian rug burns and pummeled me to the floor. When Kelcie and I were younger, we would fight, and we almost made a game out of it. She would always beat up on me because I was smaller, but when I hit my growth spurt, and I know it's not much, I was able to defend myself, and Kelcie quickly called quits on the game. But to this day, she still isn't one you'd want to mess with.
Or how about the time that Kelcie and I came to know Manuel over at the local hardware store on a first-name basis? After 6 trips to the store while trying to construct our own custom pig pens in her backyard. And although Kelcie's strength for pouring concrete and pounding posts must have come from her steady workout and diet regimen of watching The Big Bang Theory and eating gallons and gallons of buffalo wing sauce and chicken dinosaur bites, this task was much more difficult than we had ever imagined.
Kelcie is also the best driver you will ever meet. One time, she decided to pull little Dukes of Hazzard in her Mustang. As we came around a corner going about 60 miles an hour, before we knew it, a wooden pallet tried to cross the road in front of us and sent 2 wheels of that Mustang flying up in the air.
Kelcie is also a world-class dancer. And if you've never seen one of her moves, just ask. Any given Tuesday night last year, you could find Ms. Jones at the front of our gym Zumba class. Zumba, for those of you who don't know, is a Latin-inspired fitness dance party dedicated to burning calories. With Kelcie's mad, crazy leg dancing techniques, it sure was one party. Especially with the international music we couldn't quite understand and all of the middle-aged women surrounding us.
Maybe we joke about our interesting times in the past, but when you get down to it, this year has been extremely hard for both of us. Although Kelcie was often miles away, she was still able to motivate me to get involved in my FFA chapter. She has continued to be the most positive influence in my life, and her dedication to this organization has helped me find my passion in the FFA.
Not a day went by that we didn't miss you, Kels, but it made it all a little bit easier knowing that you were having an amazing time getting to know the members of California FFA and create more of these good times with them.
Giving her retiring address entitled 100% and 10,000 hours,
California FFA, give it up for my best friend
and my sister,
Ms. Kelcie Jones.
Exactly 1 year ago tomorrow, one of the most humbling and life-changing experiences took place in my life. I remember it like it was yesterday. I was standing in the San Joaquin region, surrounded in a close huddle by those who I have grown to know and love throughout my FFA career. The lights dropped, and the music played. It was time for the announcement of the 2012-2013 State FFA Officer Team. One by one, office by office, names are being called. By the time they reach the announcement of State Secretary, I'm gripping the hands of those around me tighter than you can imagine. But soon enough, the sound of my name echoed through the arena, and I was launched up the stage to join my new team. Cannons exploded confetti through the air. Loud music played, the crowds cheered, and I received my association jacket. On the outside, you may have seen a brand new state FFA secretary smiling from ear to ear and ready to take on anything this year threw at me. But on the inside, that was far from true. You see, the moment I stepped foot on this stage, doubt began to consume me. I started to compare myself to my own teammates and wasn't really sure if I even deserved to be here. I lacked self-confidence. Self-confidence makes a huge difference in everything we do. When thinking about some of the most confident people I know, they also seem to be some of the happiest. One of the largest misconceptions about self-confidence is that if you naturally struggle with it, You can't overcome that. But that's not true. If you're anything like me, self-confidence is an uphill battle and a decision you must make every morning when you begin your day. But the reward is worth the struggle, and there are ways to gain self-confidence. To start, we can't be afraid to fail. I remember my very first FFA election. My sophomore year of high school, I decided to run for South Valley Sectional Office. After filling out the application, brushing up on my interview skills, and spending days upon days rehearsing my speech, I was ready to go. When I arrived at the election, I was informed that there were 6 spots available on the officer team and only 9 candidates running for the position. My odds were good. After the most terrifying interview of my life, I had to pour everything I had into my speech to make sure it was the best that it could be, remembering every voice fluctuation and movement my ag teacher had practiced with me. Soon after, it was time to reveal who was elected. Sitting on the edge of my seat, I waited as the names were called. By the time they were revealing the last name, I was praying it was mine. But it wasn't. I was not a part of the South Valley Sectional Officer team. After receiving pity hugs from my friends and a pep talk from my ag teacher, I wanted to give up. But I knew better than that. I knew that if you didn't take risks, you would never experience self-confidence. Being brought up by a family who loves hockey, one quote immediately came to mind. The great Wayne Gretzky once said that you miss 100% of the shots that you never take. This means that we can't be afraid to fail. In order to be successful and confident young leaders, we must be willing to completely fall flat on our face, just like I did in that sectional election. Go home and try that one thing you have been letting fear of failure stop you from trying. Run for an elected office, go out for a sports team, and don't be afraid to fail. If we take 100% of those shots and don't let the fear of failure hinder us, we'll be more confident in our skills and abilities, and in turn, ourselves. Another way to gain confidence and to encourage success within our lives is to work hard and surround ourselves with things we are passionate about. This year, I had the opportunity to stay with my friend Carolyn Maxwell on a chapter visit at Sierra High School. From the moment I set foot in Carolyn's room, I felt as though I had walked into a completely different planet, one that Carolyn had created herself. Across the walls of her room draped cutouts from fashion magazines and articles of clothing that she loved. It didn't take me long to realize Carolyn's passion for fashion. In order to push herself towards a successful career in fashion merchandising, Carolyn works hard to surround herself with the things and people that motivate her. She stays close to her family because she knows that they are her support system for her dreams in the fashion industry. And Carolyn collects and subscribes to dozens of fashion magazines to make sure that she's up to date on all trends. She also works hard to keep her grades up in order to keep all opportunities open. Carolyn constantly fights the battle of self-confidence by being confident in her knowledge base of the fashion industry. If we truly want to be confident, we have to take the time to be good at something, just like Carolyn does. Malcolm Gladwell, the author of Outliers, The Story of Success, has found that most people become incredibly talented at something after at least 10,000 hours of practice. We can't be confident if we expect talent and skill to simply fall into our laps. It takes hard work. We must be willing to become confident in the things we are become knowledgeable in the things we are passionate about in order to be more comfortable with ourselves and the abilities that we possess. If that means that we take a little time outside of school studying, or take time outside of CDE practice rehearsing reasons, or even practice a sport in the backyard, that's what we do. If you want to obtain confidence in yourself, work hard. Go home, put in those 10,000 hours, and be great at something. And between the blood, sweat, and tears it may take for us to get there, the limitless potential within us is completely worth it. Ronald Reagan once said that there are no such things as limits to growth because there are no limits to the human capacity for intelligence, imagination, and wonder. This means that when it comes to our abilities, the sky is pretty much the limit. But what value is that intelligence, imagination, and wonder if we keep it all to ourselves? The real value in self-confidence isn't just that we could be the cool kid in school or win an election. The real worth comes in when we take that confidence and share it with others. One of the most influential people in my life is hands down my mother. Not only is she beautiful inside and out, but she is the most hardworking and patient person that I have ever met. A few years ago, my mother decided to take a risk, work hard, and find a way to pass on that confidence to others. While being a wonderful wife, an amazing mom, and cooking dinner every night, she pursued an education in the area of physical training. After receiving one of the most prestigious certifications possible, my mom felt confident in her abilities to work with others. She then decided to take that confidence and share it with our community by working with ladies who had suffered from strokes, injuries, and a horrific disease called multiple sclerosis. If my mom hadn't been willing to take a risk or work hard, hundreds of people in our community wouldn't have received the help that they needed. Because of the confidence that she had in herself, she was able to pass on confidence to those who she works with. Folks, if we take 100% of those shots and put in those 10,000 hours, self-confidence will thrive within us and those who we impact. Let me tell you that this will be far from easy. In my past, taking 100% of the shots wasn't always fun. For example, I was never on the varsity volleyball team. I've been rejected from colleges both years I've applied, and I've lost plenty of elections, speech contests, and tennis matches. And you know what? Putting in those 10,000 hours was not always a walk in the park either. Because I work hard, I've missed football games, birthday parties, and plenty of sleep. But you know what? I wouldn't change any of my failures or lost time for the world. To this day, I doubt myself on a regular basis, but it's because I have that 100% and 10,000 hours that I have the confidence to keep moving forward. But this year, once I zipped up this jacket, my confidence came from each of you. Whether it was my home chapter of Frontier FFA constantly providing me with encouragement, or the red team at Sacramento ALA, who gave me nothing but love and inspiration when I was frustrated with my own performance to the point of tears. Thank you for this opportunity to serve, and thank you for teaching me that it's never too late to find self-confidence. I hope that I've given you 100% and 10,000 hours this year. To my family, thank you for the never-ending love and support, and for teaching me the importance of passing on confidence to others. Although this year I wasn't always able to reciprocate that support, a day doesn't go by that I'm not thankful for each of you. To my team, thank you for standing by my side as together this year we took risks and worked hard. Thank you for the endless hugs, cooking lessons, and laughter. Thank you for teaching me so much about being a strong and confident leader. I love and appreciate each of you more than you'll ever know. Folks, we get one shot here on Earth. That's all. Don't waste your time on this planet. Don't waste your time with a mediocre life, and let self-confidence help you be exactly who you want to be. The fact of the matter is that there are thousands of people living here in America that could have changed the world forever, but won't, because they let self-doubt get in the way. Don't be afraid to take risks and put in the time to make a difference in yourself and this world. California FFA 100% and 10,000 hours. Self-confidence is a worthwhile work in progress.
It's on the line, which way you're gonna fall. In the middle, between wrong and right. But you know after all, it's your life, what you're gonna do. The world is watching you. Every day, the choices you make. Say what you want.
Kelcie. This whole year, we always talked about getting a team pet, but thanks to your leopard print style and cat-like mannerisms, you were the next best thing. There was never a shortage of fun watching you rap Nicki Minaj and snuggle with your pillow pets. Your contribution to our team
only continued with your fashionable outfits, Pinterest meals, and handbell performances. We loved that we could always count on you to put buffalo wing sauce on literally everything, rock some stripes, and clap inconveniently during our theme skit. We enjoyed witnessing your innocent comments, followed by a nose crinkle, and your dedication towards lifting one eyebrow. Your lovely personality and compassion for others was always evident in and outside of the jacket. We're not even mad. We're impressed. Through your heart of service, spunky personality, and willingness to grow, you brought this year to life for the members. Your unwavering ability to consistently encourage us provided us a sense of home for our team and played a crucial role in us becoming a family. Thank you for being our sweet, sincere Bakersfield girl. Let's bounce, Cheetahs. XOXO, Leah, Jason, Tyler, Kyle, and Hannah. California MFA, your 2012-2013 State MFA Secretary, Ms. Kelcie Jones.